Finally! Come on, please! Okay, guys, this may be my last stream, so tell my sponsors that I love them. Alright, guys, make sure to slap that like button and hit that follow for more daily updates, hopefully. Alright, guys, so as I promised, a new FIFA, alright? Oh my god! Ah! Hey, shit, another 100 gen print, so I just let you back off!
Did you just assume that I'm alone?
Hey,
how you doing?
I do for you. Any chance you got change for a 20?
Yeah, sure.
Ten 2 5s.
Can I get 4 5s?
Give me a moment.
Please pardon this interruption from your regular scheduled broadcasting. Last night, we lost a very influential member to our society. A YouTube gamer was found dead deep in the woods in a tent.
Ah, very influential indeed.
More influential than you, Rachel.
At least I can sustain a marriage, Jim. Investigations show that he may have been murdered by multiple people, possibly more than his average viewers on streams.
How many is that? 3?
This is a murder, Jim.
All right, coming up next, Cousin It finally granted citizenship to the United States.
As enticing as that sounds, that may have to wait for now.
Hey, catch your 5s.
I think.
What's that about?
I don't know, probably just some more fake news. YouTuber killed by mysterious group. I don't know, that sounds pretty serious.
Nah, don't worry about it. You remember that story they had last month? What was it? The transgender killed their father.
Ah.
Yeah, just some teenagers trying to get famous. See, same idiots probably behind this one.
Huh. You're probably right.
Hey, here's your 5.
This is a murder, Jim.
Thanks. Have a good one.
Hey. You too, bud.
Thanks, pal.
A YouTube gamer was found dead.
Give me the fucking money now!
What? You alright?
Oh my goodness, thank you so much. That man was about to kill me if he didn't get my purse.
You just let me know if he comes back here again.
Who are you?
Classified information, man. A lot of bad guys out there who'd like to know the same exact thing.
Well, can I have your number?
No.
Well, how the fuck am I supposed to call you when he comes back?
Well, I guess the whole let me know if he comes back thing was just a formality, really. I guess you could carry pepper spray or something. There's a lot of different options when it comes to having something to protect yourself in a dangerous situation, such as the one you were just put in.
Pepper spray? Well, where do you suppose I put that?
Your purse.
My purse? Right. So let me get this straight. While my attacker is trying to grab my purse, I'm supposed to reach into my purse while he's still attacking me, pull out the pepper spray, spray his eyes with the pepper spray that I can't even get out of my bag in the first place. How's that supposed to make any sense?
Yes. Oh shit, he's still there!
I'm back, he's headed to the fourth floor. We have him right where we want him.
Oh, sorry. Oh shit. Come back, but... What the fuck? Oh my god. I think I lost him.
Watashi wa megasameta no yuki nakure nori soketa. Who are you? You're welcome. There are some who fear me like a flame, though I am merely a strong wind. My birth name disappeared a long time ago, when I first began my journey of justice. Watashi wa nisi juno ikai maneta. You may call me Chitose Midori Usamu, the Black Lion, who cuts down his-
I'll just call you Weeaboo Guy.
Well, please don't. Let's talk.
Alright, what's your deal, Weeaboo Guy?
That's not my name, White Devil.
What's your deal, Weeaboo Guy? You a vigilante too?
I was. Quit a long time ago. Decided to let the law handle things. Besides, I already accomplished what I was after.
Actually being Japanese?
Still working on that one. No. I ended one of the most prolific serial killer cases in history. Right here in El Palm.
The El Palm Butcher? That was you?
Indeed. Police were so grateful they wiped my file clean and allowed me to walk away a free man. I've been watching you for some time now. I think you should do the same. This life is a dangerous one. Its path leads to destruction of everything you hold dear.
But I think I'm onto something big here, Weeaboo Guy. Maybe even bigger than the butcher ever was. You know that killing yesterday? That YouTuber in his tent? I know every criminal in this town, Weeaboo Guy. And none of them, none, ever kill a kid.
So
I propose a deal. Weeaboo Guy, I can gather information from my sources, places, people, weapons, attack schedules, anything you want. And you can be there for backup. I have a family in this town, and I want them to be safe.
I told you, I'm done with that life.
Come on, Weeaboo Guy.
I told you, my name is Chitose.
Come on, Weeaboo Guy.
I know this life isn't done with you, and I know you're not done with it.
You can try to get out now, but they'll just pull you back in.
Isn't that from The Godfather?
You have one more case left in you, Weeby. Make it count.
I'll take the case. If you never call me that again.
Deal. Weeaboo guy.
Police Chief Rogers wants you in his office.
What'd you do this time? Misplace a traffic cone?
Very funny, guys.
Fuck.
Oh, Gilligan. Come in, come in. Been expecting you.
You have? Well, sir, if it's about that traffic...
No. It's not about that. It's about your performance, Elgato. You're way under quota. Do you have any idea how important traffic duty is?
Yes, sir. Yes, I do.
You know, I thought you could be able to handle traffic duty. Not mess up like the last time. Maybe I was wrong.
Police have given up active investigation for the Forest murders, though citizens are encouraged to submit helpful tips.
Not me. I'll not be submitting any tips. And I encourage all of you at home to follow suit.
Jesus Christ, Jim.
I want to live to see my kids. Do you have any kids, Rachel? No, you don't, because a man would have to be mentally handicapped or under the influence to put a ring on that. Now we head over to Dave to see what's trending.
Thanks, Jim. New this week, bees. Are they real?
You ended the investigation?
What, the bee one?
No, the tent one.
We had no choice. There was no evidence. It was like the place had been stripped clean of all suspicious activities. All we have to do is wait for him to strike again or hope it was a one-time thing.
But Police Chief Rogers, I can help. I can go to the side, make sure there's anything
missing. Gilligan, you're a good cop. But that doesn't mean you're a smart one. If El Palm's finest couldn't handle it, I don't think a traffic cop can.
It's understood, sir.
Hey, Dick.
Didn't I tell you to call me Richard from now on?
Didn't Police Chief Rogers tell you to stop doing the evidence?
Oh, hey, brother!
What's up, man?
How you been? I haven't seen you so, twisted up inside since your vacation the Ram Ranch.
I thought I told you not to talk about that. Nah, man, there's just something weird going on here. Huh? You know that kid who died in the tent yesterday?
Oh, yeah, Scout Gamer 82.
Yeah. Wait, how do you know his name?
I may or may not have donated to his Patreon to get his limited edition Naughty Scoutmaster calendar. Never finished it.
I hope we're thinking of different dead YouTubers here, brother.
Aren't we investigating him?
Well, not anymore. Police Chief Rogers called off the investigation. Something about insufficient evidence. I don't know, man. I just think it's too quick to call it off, you know? It's not every day we get a case like this.
I mean, to be fair, the last major case we had was about 5 months ago. You know, the loitering case? Still don't think that man deserved the death penalty.
Dick, we have to cover this case. I know where the scene is. There has to be some clues that the killer's left behind.
Wait, weren't you assigned traffic duty? Do you really want to go against Police Chief Rogers' orders?
Man, it doesn't matter what duty I was assigned. I did not sign up for this force to write damn tickets all day. I trained to do two things. To uphold the justice of the city, and to unfairly profile people of color.
Well, I'm game for one or two of those things. Woo!
Let's go, brother!
Yeah!
this all you listened to?
Yes. You said it was about a mile due east from here, right?
It should be, yeah.
Well then, let us go. You go Kagatame.
You know that's why I call you Weeaboo Guy, right? It's because you say shit like that.
Let us walk. Who knows how much daylight remains.
Hey, what is that? He must have been chased if this is this far from the tent.
That must be where his tent is. Smart, Weeaboo Guy, let's go. Hey!
There is a path, you fool. What a shame, man. Kid with such a promising future gone just like that.
It is a shame, but this couldn't be a town-threatening event. For all we know, this is just some internet drama. Something that happened pointlessly. Humans are bound to do terrible things for seemingly no reason.
Something just doesn't add up about this. Everything on the internet is safe, right? Yes?
Yeah.
So then, the police should have some sort of evidence against the guy who did this. He should be in cuffs by now. The butcher. Police never seemed to crack that guy, right? You know anything about what his motives were?
His target started off random. Kind Samaritans who would pick up the wrong hitchhiker. Bargoers who would stumble into the wrong alley. Teenagers going on late night drives. Then, once his reputation grew, he began to cover his tracks. Police officers who invested the case would wind up missing for days until their bodies were found, usually not in one piece. People who would try to uncover the truth themselves would come home to a dead or missing family member. Like I did.
Sorry. I had no idea.
She was my everything, my waifu. Beautiful, smart, caring. Actually Japanese. I've taken care of cases like that before, where the police were always a step behind. Thought that one would be no different. That if someone were to perish, it would have been me, in a blaze of glory. But I came home to her one night on her final breaths. I grabbed her in my arms and promised that I would give the butcher the most painful sentence to hell imaginable. And I almost succeeded. But just like most great parties, the police got in the way.
Look, man,
what's done is done. Now we just have to make sure nothing like this happens again.
Jesus!
Kankyu hito wa waru.
They just left this here? Seems like a lot of stuff in here that if the right guy got his hands on, a lot of stuff could disappear.
Let's make sure that doesn't happen.
Alright, Weeaboo Guy. I'm gonna take photos of the surrounding area. You scan for people. Let's make it fast before anybody comes over.
Too late.
I don't know why. I'm feeling kind of thirsty right now.
Maybe it's all that cocaine.
You know, now that I think about it.
Me down, look!
Didn't they call off the investigation?
They did. There should be no cops around here.
Maybe there aren't. I got a bad feeling about this.
Could these be our guys? Calm down, me down. Why would they return to the scene of the crime like
this? Because they heard the investigation was called off.
Y'all are under arrest!
Stop.
Stop making a scene, Me Down. If you keep this up, the real criminals are gonna hear us. Think about it. Would real criminals be running around with a blue bat and a stupid sword?
It's a katana.
Get the hell out of here!
Alright, they're gone. You sure those weren't our guys?
I'm pretty positive. If I'm wrong, I swear to Jefferson Davis they'll see us again.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Holy shit! Never seen anything like this before.
The worst I've seen is traffic cone violence.
Well, let's see if we can find anything to bring back to the chief. We should also report those guys who were stalking around the tent. Overheard of chief talking about a vigilante problem? Those guys certainly match the description.
All right, I'll check in here. Dick, go check the perimeter.
Again, brother. Richard.
Why is all this stuff still here?
Kill again?
What?
I think I found something.
What you looking at?
I've seen this before.
Yeah, I think we've all seen a piece of black.
I know what this is from.
How? It's literally just a tiny bit of.
When I was a kid. My father, he would always take me out for Halloween. One year, he dressed up as Darth Vader. He kept trying to lose me in the crowd. So I would, you know, tug on his cloak. And then I lost him. This was the fabric that the cloak was made out of, I remember.
Oh fuck, Darth Vader is the killer?
No! No! The same fabric as his robe.
So, they were wearing robes? What the hell does that mean?
That means we could be dealing with a cult. It would make perfect sense. The cloth, cultist robes. I mean, it could just be to throw us off. I think it's the best lead we got, though.
And you're sure about this whole cloak thing?
I bet my life on it.
This is great. With this new info, Police Chief Rogers will be forced to open up the investigation again. You know, maybe we can find those vigilantes and squeeze some info out of them, too. Police Chief Rogers might finally take me off of traffic duty. He might give you a raise. You might have enough money to buy your own cocaine.
Whoa! Whoa!
Good work, brother.
Good work. Oh!
Oh! Oh, what the hell? Oh.
Looks like I missed one. Oh well.
I'll kill you, you sick fuck! Ugh.
I suggest you throw that aside, bud. Not gonna lie, I'm pretty impressed. Not bad for a drug addict and a traffic cop. Nice work. I wasn't expecting you guys to put that together that quickly. I guess the police department has improved drastically.
What the hell do you want?
Officer Richard Me Down. Always trying to prove yourself to a family that isn't there. Then joining the police force that gave you nothing. becoming the very thing you hate the most by becoming addicted to cocaine. Making you delusional. Leading you to trust this guy. And that very mistake will be the one that leads to your death. You have any last words, Dick?
You're never gonna get away with this, you monster.
Dying ignorant. What a shame. Officer Gillian Delgado. The Oxford definition of a fuck-up. Never able to do anything right in any facet of life. Let me see if I have this right. Rogers finally gave you a chance to prove yourself, and you're gonna screw that one up too. Then what? He put you back on traffic duty? And you fuck up there as well? You're gonna die just as you lived, Delgado. A fuck-up. Any last words? That's what I thought.
Oh my Wamu. Shindy.
That means you're a bitch!
He's gone.
Well, where are you, yellow devil?
Thank you.
I thought I told you to get the hell out of here.
If we had, you would have joined your buddy in the afterlife. You should be thanking us.
Come soon enough.
He was the only one who trusted me. Look where that got him. The sun will always set, my friend. Instead of mourning its departure, one should look towards the moon, which will bathe us in light anew. Your friend was a good man, Shibun Ita. We will avenge him.
That make me feel any better?
Really? Shit, I thought it was a good monologue.
You waiting for someone to die in front of you to say that?
Actually, I just made it up on the spot.
But what if it's a new moon?
You're right. Good question. I'll have to revise that.
I'm taking this back to the station, Police Chief Rogers. I don't know what to do.
Whoa. Slow your roll right there. We don't know who those guys were. We don't know what they wanted from you. But we know they know who you are. All right? If you go back there, you're only putting yourself and everybody else there in danger.
I guess you're right, but I'm sure as hell not hanging out with you vigilante weirdos.
I don't think you exactly have a choice, my friend. If the cult surrounds you again and we're not there, I don't think you'll be walking away.
He's right, you know.
Well, isn't this great?
Look, according to that guy in the skull mask, we really don't have that much difference in what we're looking for, at least. We both seem to want the same thing, which is to stop that cult. And I suppose we have a guy's in?
Of course. Looks like this town needs one more dosage of justice.
Are you in, Officer
Delgado? Well, looks like we don't have a choice.
Welcome, my friend.
Yeah, I wouldn't go that far. So, what's our next course of actions?
Well, I don't know about you two, but it seems to me that this cult wouldn't go through all the effort just to kill one kid and a police officer. They definitely have more targets, and we have to be there prepared for when they do. Delgado, how many bullets you got left in that gun?
It's Gilligan, and I have all of them. I haven't fired this thing yet.
Make sure to make them count. Now what we do is wait for their next victim, see if we can make a connection.
Hey, what's up, all my Brahmins? Today we're back for another daily vlog. We're out here in the forest, and today we're gonna be hunting some werewolves. Heyo! Oh, and look, there's Steve over there. He's a monk now. He's taking his vow of silence. He's gonna help exorcise the werewolf.
That's not how that works.
Oh, and that's our resident werewolf expert and extraordinaire, Eric Gaydong.
I told you not to say my fucking last name.
It's okay. I'll edit it out in post.
I get embarrassed about it and I got bullied for it in high school.
Okay.
No, I won't.
You
So the werewolf that we're looking for today is named Vishnu. He's from an old Indian tale. And in that tale, it says we'll be able to find it near the dung of 1,000 peacocks meets the branch that's shaped like a flame. Oh. Whoa!
That's a lot of poop. My God.
Oh, and the sticks there too.
But where's Vishnu? He's supposed to be here.
Ah! It's Vishnu!
Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh my God! Hey, don't cuss around Vishnu. He gets mad at that.
You think I fucking care about the werewolf things?
Hey! Stop that! He can tell that this video is gonna get demonetized!
Okay.
No, I have a special task for you. I know you have the most experience with werewolves, so I'm gonna need you to shoot that thing!
Let me go!
I'm not gonna shoot the thing.
Oh, come on! There's a silver bullet in there? It's the only thing that can kill werewolves and get me a good amount of views.
You want me to kill a man on camera so you can get on trending?
Oh, come on! Just do it! Kill him! Kill him! He's getting away! Look!
It's just a prank! It's just a prank, man!
What the hell?
Holy shit, we gotta get out of here.
No, wait, what about Steve? What about Steve?
Come on.
Ah! Ah! Ah!
Okay, guys, I think we lost the people who were chasing us. I think. Well, did you see what those guys were wearing, Eric?
No. Come on. I'm trying to make a phone call. Shut up.
Okay.
Come on.
Oh my God, that was so scary. They killed Steve back there. And that random guy that I hired off of Craigslist to play a werewolf.
Come on, pick up. Probably kind of bad. Pick up.
This is gonna be the first time that I actually am able to record a video that's titled, I Almost Died, and not actually be clickbait. Okay, guys.
Come on.
I'm gonna be logging off for now. Hopefully I'll catch you guys soon.
Come on.
Bye now.
Mao, oh my God, Mao. Me and some friends, we were camping on Willie's Mountain Trail. Some people started chasing us. Yeah, they're wearing cloaks. How'd you... We saw three of them, okay? Okay. Just please come quick. You know, I know you're gonna fight. We need you, man.
Oh my God, Eric, I see them. They're coming. Eric, come on, let's go.
Okay,
let's go.
Okay, now I gotta go, okay.
No, you hang up.
Eric!
Okay, I gotta go.
Oh no, Eric!
Thanks for calling the investigation squad, bud. It'll make cleanup a whole lot easier.
Eric, no!
You bastard, you killed two people. I got one in the chamber and I'm not afraid to use it.
Oh really? Do it.
You think I'm kidding you? I'm warning you, man.
I guess we'll have to see.
What the hell? This wasn't a real gun.
Of course it's not a real gun. I'm not a murderer. I wouldn't kill anyone.
That makes one of us.
Charles, no!
That's the thing with you people. It's always an act, a show. If that gun was really loaded, you and your friend would still be alive. The time for pretending is over.
Why?
Why? Because we're about to change the world. We're going to change the way people go through life. Not as mere audience members. Active participants. Maple's coming.
He's not picking up.
Maybe he's just in a dead zone.
That's not funny.
I don't know, guys. This might be a trap.
We'll have to take that risk. That's my cousin they have.
This is no time for romance, Mao.
What?
Stop!
Whoa, what is it?
There's a stop sign.
What? Are you kidding me?
I'm sorry, I'm a traffic cop. I can't help it.
All right, we gotta go fast.
Yeah,
There's a traffic area just up ahead. There's parking near there.
Ooh, let's up. This is where his GPS last got signal.
Mao.
Yes.
Where's your mask?
I need my cousin to recognize me somehow, right?
You're kidding, right?
You mean this phone?
Yes! I mean, where could... Fuck.
I knew this was a trap, brothers!
Wait, didn't you already take your bullets in the car?
Huh?
Guys.
Yes.
Over there.
Well, well, well. Here we are. The three wrenches in my master plan.
You!
You really think that would be enough to stop me? Oh, God. All right, you guys, cover me. You got this. Yeah.
Oh, shit, brother.
You bastards are going to pay for what you did to
Come
Eric.
Come on, Mel. There's no time for that. Let's go. Come on.
You know the way out of here? Gilligan!
Hey!
Jesus Christ, bro. Come on, get up!
I get scared, man.
Wait, what?
Where's the China, man?
Oh, it's Weeaboo Guy, but... Good question.
Hey, come on. Get up, buddy. We gotta go. Come on. Come on, go!
I need to take Chitose back to base before he comes too. You stay here and finish off the others. Find them. Or else.
Man, how are we gonna get out of here now? Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Andrew Jackson was a good man?
No.
Oh shoot, there's one coming.
Hi.
Talk!
No!
Now what? Stop that! What do you suggest we do then?
Hey, bud! Hey, listen. We need to know where our friend Weeaboo Guy is. If you tell us, this will be way less painful for you. Okay? I'm gonna lift my hand up.
No! I'll never tell!
Well, that didn't work.
Well, time to bring out old reliable. Hold him down, please, ma'am.
Now are you gonna tell us?
That's all you have? I'll never tell!
Well.
Alright, Mao, you go and scope out the gas station. I'll take this guy back to the police station.
Yeah, but I'm sort of concerned about the ethics of this.
I'm not, man. It has healthy minerals, pollen string.
Oh. Right,
I'll meet up with you in 0800 hours. Wait, you don't happen to have the car keys, do you?
No.
I'll see you.
See you then.
All right, bud. More water where you're going.
So, they're in a cult with no objective and no leader. What the hell is this, Gilligan? It sounds like it was ripped out of a horrible movie idea. Are you trying to punk me?
I'm being serious, Chief. I was walking my six and I saw this lunatic with a gun. And you know this isn't an open carry state.
Well, we can hold him for a while on open carry charge. But you're gonna need more solid evidence in order to pursue this case.
Well, what counts as solid evidence then, Chief?
anything that hasn't come off your imagination, Gilligan. Until then, you're on strict probation. You let one of our best men die out there, and now you come to me with some bogus story about a cult? One more slip up and you won't even be on traffic duty. You'll be out of a job. But you better tread carefully, Gilligan. I'd say I expected more from you, but I'd be lying. I'm not a liar. Get out of my office. Chief! Get the fuck out of my office. Get your ass back to traffic duty. At least that's real.
I'm assuming all is going according to plan?
Almost. We've been completing the plan with success, but there's one small discrepancy. There's people on the case. Two rogue police officers and two vigilantes. We've managed to get one of the officers, but the other one was saved at the last moment by the vigilantes. And now the three have seemed to team up. We've already captured one of them, and I have my men out looking for the others.
We've come this far, my friend. We can't let something so minuscule get in our way.
Agreed. We will be taken care of.
If we can't solve the problem, then just work around it. Three people can't protect all of our targets. No getting sidetracked.
Understood.
Hey man, I'm gonna rob you. Give me your money. Come on. Oh, I met a guy yesterday named Rob. No, this is an action. Give me everything you fucking have.
Greedy then.
Come on, man.
Come on, man.
Excuse me!
Hey, is this Akutz's gas station? I'm looking for Akutz's gas station.
What the fuck does it look like?
Is it? That guy's
probably. No! I'm ruined! With all my money!
Akutz, I assume? I need your help.
What the fuck?
Language? Anyways, I heard from a certain anonymous source that a Japanese imitator is being held hostage here in your gas station. Is this true?
No, sir. I do not know. And even if I did, what reason would I have to tell you?
Listen, mister.
You think I fear you? There's one thing I fear in this world, and it sure isn't some wannabe vigilante with some t-ball bat.
I'm not a vigilante. I'm a specialist.
But at what, sir?
Vigilantism. But that doesn't make me a vigilante.
But that makes you a vigilante.
Shut up and tell me what I need to know.
And what reason do I have to tell you that, sir?
Yukusu no kore desu. Wasekusu.
Talk as loud or as much as you want, Shintose. No one can hear you. Hell! No one can understand what you're saying anyway.
How did you know my name? Nani?
Ah, yes. I know your name. Although, I like what your friends have been calling you a lot more. Weeaboo Guy. It encapsulates everything you are. A fraud.
You know nothing about me, Skullman.
I know more than you think.
Sir! Sir! We couldn't find the other investigators, and Tim is nowhere to be found. It is possible that he has been captured.
Ah, not that big of a deal. We'll be done here soon anyway.
You!
Look, man, I'm not interested in the current buying price of Build-A-Bear stock and how it affects our economy. Look, I know you know where Weeaboo Guy is, and I need you to tell me now!
I know, sir, but you see, if Build-A-Bear were to lose its Disney sponsorship... No.
I swear to fucking God.
Okay,
you don't
sir,
tell me
I
now.
Know what your Buddhism stealing friend is, but what reason do I have to tell you?
Great to see you, man.
I saw a guy running down the street with some money, and I think he had a gun. Did you see him here?
I don't think so.
The butcher, you should be in prison. I put you there myself.
How the hell are you?
Please, Weeaboo Guy. I thought we knew each other better. You can call me Eddie.
Answer my question, you monster! And why is my shirt off?
Why should I? You're a dead man talking. Chitose?
My escape was inevitable. Have those police ever been able to do anything right? You should have killed me when you had the chance. Ignored those pigs! We work on the outside of the law. We have that in common.
We have nothing in common.
Oh, but we do. We both have that drive. Work on the outside of the law. Don't let the police get in our way. I've always respected you for that. Too bad I had to kill your wife to get you here.
Don't you even mention her name, you devil spawn.
You know I've always enjoyed taking life. But hearing her scream was the most satisfying. And watching you cry, promising her you'd kill me. But now look at you. All alone. Ready to be killed by me.
Sir, we've located the Doomsday Guy. Ready when you are.
I'll only be a minute more. Where were we? You have to understand, Weeaboo Guy. This time it's gonna be different. Sequels can't just be retreads of the originals. No. You have to expand the lore. Expand the universe. And that's exactly what we're here to do.
You're here to die. You and your cult.
I wouldn't call us a cult. More like an interest group.
Interest groups don't kill people for no reason.
Yes, they do. Look at Peter.
To be fair, you haven't tried everything.
Everything, huh? Well, have you tried this?
No, he hasn't.
Now listen here, you stubborn, swindling fuck. The entire fate of Elpom Hell, the entire fate of this great country lies on where that wannabe foreigner is. Now you're gonna tell me exactly where he is, or things here are gonna get ugly. Uglier than Sherman's march to the sea.
No, I will never tell.
Tell me, bitch! What are you doing?
I got an idea. Akut.
Pretty please?
There in the back.
But you see, Weeaboo Guy, that's where you're wrong. This time my killings, our killings, have meaning. We have a message. And we plan to spread it to one of the most impressionable audiences on the planet.
Who? Teenagers? K-pop followers?
No. Well, kind of. YouTube. You see, YouTube's one of the most impressionable audiences in the world. And once they see our message, everyone will be a part of our interest group. You see, the problem is the YouTube algorithm's too hard to crack. The top channels stay on top. Well, the solution is the top channels need to stop producing content.
So you're gonna kill them.
You see, it's not that hard to understand the meaning. Start from the bottom and work your way up. Eventually there's no competition. And you can kill all who stand in your way.
What message could be important enough to kill innocent people over?
You know? I'm glad you asked. Because Maple is coming.
Fucking damn it! Don't this!
Hey!
Hey! Hey!
end of the last time. You guys can handle this. I'm gonna go take some ibuprofen. Probably way more than I should.
Hey!
Hey, get out of here, bud.
Go!
Hey!
Weeaboo Guy, are you all right?
Where is he? Oh.
Yes, I'm all right. More importantly, I have good news. I know what their motives are, and I know who their leader is.
Oh, spit it out already! We don't have time to spare in like these fruity robe-wearing cultists!
Is everything alright back here, boys? Would you like to buy a lottery ticket? Oh my god, it's just like the Jolly on Warabog massacre. I got this. We're going to need bleach, lye, and a bathtub. Okay, boys, I got this.
Boy, you better get the hell out of here! You harbored the cult!
They paid me a lot of money, which Rob just stole.
I don't think his name was actually Rob.
YouTubers. The answer's been in front of us the entire time. They're targeting YouTubers whose videos have reached the trending tab. They're killing their way up, erasing those channels, getting more exposure, so that they could eventually convert the entire internet.
In that case, we should just go to YouTube and have them shut them down, right? They could just ban the cult's entire platform.
YouTube doesn't understand their own terms of service. How do you expect them to stop a serial killing cult?
What he said, everyone knows they don't care about their users.
Shut up! You're probably subscribed to T-Series.
How did you know?
We should just bring him to the police then, right? I mean, they already have a cultist in custody. They ought to just reopen the case.
I wouldn't be too sure. If I go to Police Chief Rogers with more cult leads, he's gonna fire me. We need evidence, or we're gonna get nowhere.
I wouldn't be too sure about the police, Mao. I found out who the man in the skull mask was. It was Eddie Cow, the El Pump butcher himself.
That's a load of bull! He's been in custody for as long as I can remember.
Then get a better memory, Gilly-san. I would recognize that face anywhere.
Jesus, to think they've already broken a serial killer out of prison. How the hell could that have happened?
I mean, he was scheduled for transport last month. I didn't hear anything, so I thought it was all right. I mean, at least I thought so.
You thought so?
It took me many moons to put him away. It cost me everything. My wife. My pride. Now all of that was thrown away for nothing. Right before he was about to kill me, he said something, like a calling card.
What did he say?
Maple is coming.
Maple is coming?
How can a tree come? If there's a humanoid tree, I say that's important. We need to stop them.
But he said.
They said something about a doomsday guy, and I think I know who that is. He created that video last week on how to obtain the nuclear launch codes. We should start trying to locate him immediately. He's a man who creates extremely realistic, apocalypse-level scenarios.
Ah! Yellowstone just got nuked! Oh fuck, I'm gonna dodge this fireball now! Watch this! You see that? Fucking turbo! Whoa! And now? Finally, step 7, use your water bending to put out the fire. All right, guys, that was my Yellowstone gets a nuke scenario. And next week, we'll be going over the Build-A-Bear loses its Disney sponsorship scenario. Oh fuck, that's gonna be fucking crazy!
Thanks for watching.
Mr. Dane, Mr. Dane, you're in danger.
Oh, the Confederacy won the Civil War scenario. Step one, locate the nearest African-American for assistance.
Ah,
Japan deflects the atomic bomb scenario. Step one, grab the nearest deck of Uno playing cards.
All right, buddy, I'm gonna have to stop you right there.
Exploding eyeball scenario.
Look, man, we're just here to help. There's a group of men who want to see you dead.
Okay. You got lucky this time. So who's next? The KGB? The CIA want a rematch? The Himalayan Eskimo people want their land back? I can take any of them.
Japan could have deflected the bombs.
There wouldn't have been anime if they had.
I need to sit down.
No, focus, y'all, focus. No, a cult is after you. And they're trying to kill YouTubers so they become the most popular YouTube channel.
A cult? I haven't made a cult scenario yet.
Are you kidding me?
It might have offended the prepper cult I started. Let me think.
I believe the best course of action is to transport you out of the area and hide you until we can find a way to deal with this madness.
Doomsday Dave doesn't hide. Doomsday Dave is the danger. Besides, if I hide, I'll lose the element of surprise, the upper hand. I'll get killed in my fucking sleep. Do you know how much that would fucking suck? I won't be able to sleep. My eyes.
Jesus above, man. Calm down.
Hey,
all right. We'll get you a flight out of here.
I'm on a no-fly list.
Why?
I once made a plane no-fly. No wing scenario.
What?
Okay, fine, then what do you suggest we do?
Okay. I got it. Here's me. Here's the cult. Here's you guys.
Oh! Ha.
Okay, so if everything goes as planned,
uh-huh.
I'll jump out of the dumpster and...
Oh, hey! What are you doing here?
All right, Weeaboo Guy, take the right. Gilligan and I will
stay... Stop! No need. Step aside, I got this.
Do it, man.
Step one. Two steps to the left. One.
Fuck! We can't find him now. Step two. Die.
No!
You know, this is what vaccines do to your body, you know.
Shut up.
So this week, it seems like God is giving us a pretty clear forecast. But North Korea isn't. From what I'm hearing, it seems that 25 nuclear warheads are being fired at the United States from the Pacific Ocean. They're being somewhat effective on that pesky coast.
We have some really important breaking news. We'll get back to you in a second.
Hello all. We're very sorry to interrupt today's weather forecast, but we have some very important breaking news.
Shut up, Rachel. We are not sorry at all. New this hour, 4 people have been found missing deep in the woods. A famed daily vlogger, Charles Dawson Xavier IV, a werewolf hunter, a monk, and a fiber actor have all gone missing. What a group. Doesn't that sound like a nice trip with the boys?
Wouldn't you know, Jim? One time you went on a fishing trip and forgot it was your anniversary. And you wonder why the judge favored her.
The interesting thing to note about the disappearance are the similar circumstances it has to the murder of the gaming streamer that happened earlier this week. Another YouTuber. Could there be a connection there?
Like that connection between you and that high school intern, right?
At least I don't fucking eat people, Rachel.
Okay, and that ends our breaking news segment. Back to Jill with whatever she was talking about. Jill?
Jill? Hello? Are you fucking deaf?
Thanks, Rachel. Now back to the weather report. So, good news! The nuclear warheads turned out to be duds. But, hold on. I'm now receiving word that Kansas is on fire.
Enough is enough, guys. There's a clear connection between those murders now. Not even the chief can deny that there's a group at play with an agenda.
The chief, so you're going back to the station?
Yeah, truth is, we need all the help we can get, and the cops here may not be the best, but, you know, I trusted with my life.
That may be a mistake. I trusted the police. Only once.
Oh my god, shut up about your dead wife already! Jesus Christ!
Gilligan! At least I have a dead wife. Baka.
Whatever, I'm going back to the station. If we do our job right, you guys can take it easy for a while.
I sure hope so, Gilligan. In the meantime, we'll go to Akutsu's. See who the next target is, you know?
Alright, I'll see you. And, right. Assuming that I work with the police for the rest of this cult ordeal, Mao, you're a fine man, but, you should really invest in a new weapon. You know, bats are for gays and wife beaters. Which one are you?
Since when are bats gay?
And Weeaboo Guy, you realize this is a fake katana, right?
What?
It literally has a Kilbo reference engraved on it. Now, where'd you get this? Comic-Con?
This day wounds me with every hour.
Whatever. I'll see you guys. Stay out of trouble.
Bats are cool, right?
Let us go, my friend.
It's a bat.
Sir! Sir! There you are, Gilligan. I've been looking for you. Do you know how many speeding tickets you've written in the last 2 days?
That's not what this is about!
Zero! You know, I'm starting to think you've been working on that false lead of yours again. We questioned that guy that you brought in the other week, off the street. Some random homeless person. This is strike three, Gilligan. I'm done
with— Sir! Have you been watching the news at all recently? 4 more YouTubers died, and there's one more that I still need to call in. It's clear who they're targeting, and I have the intel that can tell me who they're gonna target next and why they're doing it.
Well, why?
They want to become the most famous YouTube channel, sir. And I have a witness that can attest to that. His name is Akins, and he's the owner of a gas station, and he can confirm that this is not only a cult that we have on our hands, but the guy I brought in yesterday lied his way out of punishment.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Gilligan, how did you manage to get a witness?
Anonymous tip, sir.
Well, we can't get anywhere with this case without any leads.
Oh, that's just it, sir. I know who the leader of this cult is, and I know how we can narrow down the list of next victims and possibly save some of them.
You hear about Kansas? Man, who gives a fuck about Kansas, bro? Delgado's been in there a while. What is he talking about? Hopefully begging for his job back. I'm getting tired of his laziness. So am I, bro, so am I. Say, didn't we get a domestic abuse call before? We should probably go answer that.
Yeah. Or we could choke on some Dunkin'.
Yeah, let's beat it!
So you're telling me the butcher escaped through transit and none of us heard about it?
Well, sir, that's what it looks like.
Jesus. If what you're saying is true, we need to put an end to this immediately. This could be the end of El Palm as we know it. Alright, Delgado. Putting an officer on each YouTuber within 5 trending spots of Doomsday Day. Good job, officer.
Thank you. Sir, I just want what's best for this town, so which YouTuber do you want me on?
Slow down there, Gilligan. I'm not sure if I want you on this case.
What?
You see, good lead or not, you went against direct orders. And you're lucky I haven't taken your badge by now.
But, sir...
I'm putting Davis and Walton on this case.
Those two? Those two are the most incompetent people I can imagine!
I don't think you have the right to talk about incompetence, Gilligan. You see this shotgun? This is what I used to finally get the El Palm Butcher to stand down. Which got me promoted to police chief. After he murdered the chief before me. Without this shotgun, his reign of tyranny would have lasted for God knows how long. Killing many more people before I stopped it. This shotgun is a symbol of power and the drive to stop those who've wronged innocent people. Although you did uncover much of this case, Gilligan, I'm sorry, but I can't let you close it. I've stopped this monster once before, and I'd be the best bet in knowing how to stop him again. I'm putting those two on the case and that's final.
But sir!
That's final, Gilligan! Besides, I suspect you've been sleeping with my wife.
Sir, that's absurd! Are me and your wife related in any sort of way?
No.
Then there's no way in hell it was me!
All the same, Gilligan. Anyways, your work on this case is over. Now go back to traffic duty. Really, this time. If it wasn't for you getting those leads, you'd be handing your badge over right now. Now go.
All right, sir. Ah, would you look who came running back? What happened? Chief didn't trust your lead?
No, he did. He just didn't trust me. I feel like one of them shifty gypsies right now, I tell you,
okay, boy. Okay, none of that. He did? You're telling me you got the whole El Palms Police Department on our case and you're not even there to know their movements?
Why does it matter? The police are taking care. Just take a break.
You think either of us would trust the police alone with an investigation of this scale? This cult is like a whale. You need a dozen harpoons to bring it down.
That's why I like you boys. Where are we headed next?
Prank Nation. Guy lives about half an hour uptown. He's the next step up from Doomsday Dave in popularity.
You're sure he's the right guy?
I am. Bet my life on it.
Don't say that.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, you guys cannot climb in here without buying anything. Raddi da bakka!
This is where the Twitter said they were. I can't see them.
They could be anywhere. How do we know where to look?
Well, based on what I saw on YouTube, if you see a group of guys making asses of themselves and being really loud, well, those are the guys.
You just described 90% of El Pop.
Ah, oh my god, Della Tony! Oh, you go! Tony, babe, what are you doing down there?
Oh lord, what's happening here?
Help, I'm having a seizure.
Oh, okay, okay.
Seizure.
Don't worry. I'll call 911. They'll know what to do. Oh!
Ah, you totally fell for it, bro.
What in the name of mental retardation?
Hey! That wasn't even funny, you just straight up attacked him.
It's gonna make us bank though. Hey. Plus, it's all about the reactions.
Come on, man. We're gonna have to edit out the retard though. Are you trying to get us demonetized?
Can we leave them?
Listen, you two. With each passing minute, death becomes more and more inevitable. Your family and friends will mourn you at first, then they will forget. The internet will forget. But you still have time to change this fate. You still have time to fulfill your legacy so that your flame will go out with a roar and not a sizzle.
Tony, I think we should go now.
Oh, come on, John. It's the classic reverse prank. It's like that guy from the pushing wheelchairs over video. It's the same exact thing.
I think you just wanted help getting up, man.
Guys, I'm being serious. We have to go.
Oh, hush, you stupid ninja. Come on, bro. Let's just keep filming.
Okay.
Look, there's a guy over there.
Oh, nice.
Watch this.
Wait, no!
You got something on your shirt there, mister.
Oh. Tony, no! Ow. No! Tony! Oh my god, Tony, no! Oh my god!
Damn it!
The sun will always set in the east. Should we not look towards the full moon for guidance, rather than the darkness?
Would you stop with all the idioms? If you would have told them that the cultists were after them, they would have still been alive.
The one who speaks in silence shall always be heard the loudest. Idioms are the key to achieving this.
Who you call an idiot?
Is it just me, or does that blood look more like jelly filling than blood?
Shut up, you fat ass.
Hey, I'm on a diet, okay?
Sir, I don't make a lot of money. There is a lot of money left in the world.
You know what? Nah. Give me the money! Come on, give me the fucking money! Come on, give me the fucking money! Hey! Give me the fucking money, man!
Not joking around. Holy shit. Come on, I'll have a fucking day. Come on. Come on.
Sir, please. Working here could be a way for you to legally obtain the money. What is so fucking hard to understand about that? You come here every day anyways. Wouldn't it be easier for all parties?
You dropped something.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
Have a good one.
See you, gentlemen.
Hey, Coots, we need your help.
Is no one going to call the police?
I'll do it.
I don't have time for that.
Listen, we need to use the internet. Do you have a computer in the back or something like that?
Yes, but I do not know about the internet.
Why? Why do you have a computer but no internet?
Do not open the homework folder.
Homework? You're not in any sort of
school. Okay, right this way. Okay, so I ask you all to look away for a second. Okay, you guys can come now.
All right, let's just get to work.
I'll grab the computer. I assume you two have your phones.
Right here.
All right, you guys use your little Satan ringers and go on YouTube. Let's find his next target. Hey, Coots, what are all these pop-ups?
Oh, those are my Nigerian cousins. The royalty, you know.
You know what they say, all Indians know each other.
Nigeria isn't...
Mao! Get to work, brother! Gosh!
I should get a seeking code. I should get a seeking code.
What are we gonna see? Magic versus Knicks? Them boys suck.
Weeaboo Guy, you found anything? I looked around every forum I could find, but nobody's talking about a cult.
Yes, I have.
Pack
these
farm
YouTubers
is the way to
and
go.
Some other ones are the ones I've decided are in the biggest danger of the cult right now. They're near the rest in terms of popularity.
And location's probably a factor too. Isn't it sort of peculiar that all these YouTubers live within a short car ride distance from us?
Oh, Palm is the YouTube capital of the world. You didn't know that?
Seems awfully convenient.
It matters not. Look, these YouTubers are just people who want to do good in the world and create a better society. And the cult is taking that away. They're systematically oppressing a group of people and targeting them for crime. Who would do something like that? We can't allow this to continue. We cannot keep letting innocent people die.
Weeaboo Guy, keep it up. We'll head out soon. I'm gonna see what Gil is up to. Any luck? You've been at it for hours.
Oh, what the hell are you doing?
Okay, I got a little sidetracked.
Gilligan, why in God's name would you look that up?
I need to prove he's a hooligan.
It's been 5 hours, and you still-
Alright, guys. I have a plan of attack. I think I know who the cultists want to target next. But I'm split between two channels.
Which ones?
The first one is a tutorial channel that uploads every other day. They taught me everything I know. How to wash my clothes. How to ride a bike. How to act on a first date. They were the father I never had.
We'll protect them, Weeaboo Guy.
The second one is a stoner channel. He takes various illegal drugs, reviews their price and effect. Through him, I learned how to roll joints, take acid, and overdose on heroin the right way.
You do that stuff?
No. But I can now because of him. We have to save him. He was the depressing uncle I never had.
This sounds like a load of bullshit.
Hey, this is my lore dump.
I built the stoner so I could arrest the degenerate afterwards.
Hey, stay away from Larry, son.
Guys. Duh. Guys, I don't like it, but it sounds like we should split up.
I don't know, brother. When America tried that, we lost 500,000 of our best men. And a couple of northerners, too.
It might be the only way we ensure we don't lose one of ours again. Weeaboo Guy, you and me will take Larry.
Whoa, 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 nah, ah. Just because you're a fancy-smancy YouTuber doesn't mean you escaped the long arm of the law.
Mel, I'll take Larry with Gilligan. I think he needs to be carried anyway.
Well, hold on a minute.
Hey, do you think you could protect Tutorial Haven on your own?
You can count on me.
I know I can.
All right, guys, let's get ready and get to those YouTubers as quick as possible. Let's hope that history has not repeated itself, that the enemy has not crossed the Delaware in the middle of the night.
Wrong war.
Are you guys really not—
Fuck off!
It's okay, Kutz, my friend. With every passing sunset, there is a sunrise, and then there is light.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Trevor. My name is Hector, and welcome to Tutorial Haven. And today, we have something very special for you. Get it, guys? We're having a rap battle.
Trevor, you're so funny. I love you.
Please, please, I have a family, a wife, and kids. I have a steady job at McDonald's. What would the other workers say? Like, all right, dude, what the fuck you do? Get the fuck off my horse. Like, I have a black guy who's coming tomorrow. What, like, please, please, show me. No, tengo familia, y esposa, y hijos, y tengo un trabajo en McDonald's, y tengo un concierto de Black Eyed Peas mañana. Por favor, show some.
Damn it, they're fast.
Why are you ringing the damn doorbell?
All right, you know the drill.
Seems like death from gunshot wounds, but the powder burns indicate close-range combat.
Say, who would win in a fight? An octopus with a knife in each arm, or a polar bear?
Definitely a polar bear.
Do you know how big those things are? Hell, you can stab one of them 20 times and it won't go down.
Wait, what about an African penguin with the Glock 19 against a zebra with a machete?
Well, maybe if it was an emperor penguin, but an African one's got no shot.
This isn't good. Have they really given up already?
Don't know much about history. Don't know much biology.
Jay said I told you I want your shitty ass coat. The alpaca stuff now.
I have your ketamine ready. I told you I've watched him before.
Give me a second.
Right.
Oh, why, hello, officer.
Hide the ketamine.
Son, I'm not here to arrest you. You see, we came here together to warn you. We are vigilantes from El Palm. My name's Gilligan, and you can call him Weeaboo Guy. You see, we help people who we suspect are targets of... of a deadly cult who have been killing off YouTubers one by one, and we think you might be next.
Oh my god, really?
Yes. Stay here while... Where did he go?
An interesting vanishing maneuver. Let's find out.
What do you want from me? Money? Drugs? Of which I have none.
As my comrade was saying, we suspect you are in grave danger. We want you to just stay here and make sure nothing suspicious happens.
As a great man once said, Watashi wa tuba mesu ichizu. Your safety is our number one priority.
Safety? I can protect myself. What can you do to keep me safe?
Well, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna stay here, and we're gonna wait for those guys after you, and then we're gonna put an end to them.
Who is that guy?
Oh, him? I'm not sure how long he's been there, but I'm pretty sure his head's stuck in, like, 1969.
Never mind the dark man over here. We have to protect you.
Fine, you can stay. But as long as you're staying in this house, you gotta remain elevated.
I don't really do that. I'm not comfortable.
It's pretty fucking apparent that you're not into this, you fuck. What, are you scared of the ass of ghost demons? If you want to stay here, you gotta fucking do this shit.
It's a cult. Fine.
Nice. Alright, you wanna be up first?
I guess.
Alright.
Lightweight.
Alright, it's your turn. Smooth, right?
Hey, Gilligan. I'm you.
What?
Hey, man, chill.
Just let him go on his journey. You feeling it, man?
I feel like I just accidentally shot Stonewall Jackson.
Exactly.
No, I thought you were actually made of stone.
My wife.
Are you alright, man?
Yeah, I just... Water.
Look up here, I'm in heaven. I've got scars that can't be seen. I've got drama can't be stolen. Everybody knows me now.
Heaven.
So high.
Yeah, we got
Wake up, man.
What car are you in?
I was on vacation.
I said I was sorry, Snowball.
Too late. The boss is already here.
What?
Now you're excited to fight like a man, Weeaboo Guy.
Mommy.
This should be easy enough.
Stay back, I know how to use this.
No, you don't.
Shit. Move out of the way, Stonewall. I don't want to have to live with the pain again.
I'd shoot a Confederate any day.
Shit, I'm sorry. It wasn't me this time, Stonewall. I'll fulfill your legacy.
Come on, man. You gotta control your high.
It's what he would have said.
This is why you don't give hillbillies drugs.
You killed my wife.
I'd kill her again. Maybe I'll dig her up and put another knife in her heart.
I had her cremated.
Then I'll,
Won't you go to him then?
I think we're stuck here, brother.
You think I'm your brother?
Nah, that's just something I say, like y'all are cornbread.
I think you're my brother too, officer. We're all brothers on this crazy planet. I'd die for you.
I mean, Hardin here's been pretty effective so far.
Take this, you demon hallucinations!
Larry, they're not hallucinations! Larry, I told you not to leave the spot, man.
It's my destiny, man.
To die a useless death like John Wilkes Booth?
No one dies on this astral plane, man. Our energy will go on forever, as will I.
Does that mean if Mr. Wilkes Booth is out there, that somewhere there might be some hope? Damn it!
What the hell?
I got the guy, boss. Let's get out of here.
See you soon, Weeaboo Guy.
I want to go back to traffic duty. The walls, man. The walls are moving. I can't see.
I'm guessing this didn't go very well.
How are you feeling, Gilligan?
Why are my hands evil?
This is gonna be harder than I thought.
And that's why a man who broke 25 plates over a poison dart frog may be the first use of the death penalty since that loitering case.
What an interesting situation. Thank you, Dave. Moving on, we have more breaking news.
Are we gonna ignore that headline? Oh, okay, Jim, I see
how it is. Shut up, bitch. You look like a frog and be lucky you don't have any more plates. Back to the breaking news. Four more YouTubers were found dead in their respective homes.
Doomsday Dave, who has no correlation with our wonderful coworker Dave, was found dead in his home with multiple bullet wounds in his chest. Guess you could say he wasn't prepared for that.
Just like how Wyoming wasn't prepared for those Alaskan bush people. The next two YouTubers were a pair who ran a channel called Tutorial Haven. Their contributions will not be forgotten.
Haven? That should sound very familiar to you, Jim.
That's right, Rachel. Good times.
Finally, a YouTuber by the name of Larry Mintz has been found dead. He was a popular drug reviewer who taught people how to enjoy the riches of life safely. You could have used some of those drug safety tips, huh, Jim?
one time.
As this YouTuber purge becomes more of an evident problem, there are only but a few questions to ask. When will this madness stop? And is there anyone who can save us from these acts of terror?
I can't believe you guys. I thought we were going to be professional about this. And now you go and do this? That's another YouTuber's blood on your hands.
Look. It was in the YouTuber's best interest that we did that. Okay? We had pure intentions. And I am ready to fight.
I want to eat the ceiling cotton candy.
So were you ready to fight when he died?
Look, what's done is done. It can't be changed. What I do know is that we still have time to save the rest. We've let 9 people die so far, and that is a burden that cannot be easily lifted. But I do know that if we try and keep our heads and keep our wits about us, that no more shall perish in the face of this evil cult.
Weeaboo Guy, I'm with you if you truly believe what you're saying.
Mao, I will put 100% of myself into this. I will make sure that no one else will suffer at the hands of these monsters. Are you with me?
Since day one.
Gilligan, are you with me? Then let us go. From this day forward, no one else shall perish.
50 more YouTubers are dead.
The entertainment industry is quite literally dying, and so is El Palm's population.
In our last broadcast, I made a desperate cry for help, and it seems that none of you have listened. Well, if one of you did listen and did attempt to try and save the YouTubers, you fucking suck.
We need some positivity up in here. Let's cut to Dave. Guys, cut to Dave. Guys.
Thanks, Jim and Rachel. I have some good news to report. The El Palm Slippery Slimy Erotic Eels have won the AAA Baseball Championship.
It's minor league baseball, but hearing it from Dave made it pretty bearable. And that guy is thicker than a bowl of oatmeal.
Well, do we have anything else? Jill, tell us about some cool weather news.
It's weather. How can it possibly be cool?
Thanks, guys. I'm aware that you guys are looking for positive news, but I'm afraid I have none of that.
You know what, Jill? Jill, stop talking. We don't want to hear any of that. Let's just go back to Dave. Can we get Dave on screen?
Dave, where are you, you sneaky guy?
Good news, guys. I have confirmation that bees are, in fact, real.
Yes!
Let's go!
Come here. Let's go!
Whip! Let's go, sister.
Wow, Dave, that was really great.
Yeah, Dave, thanks for that. That really made my day. I love you, Dave. Where were we? Oh, that's right, Jill was saying something. Hey, Jill, you want to finish what you're saying over here?
All right. As I was saying, I'm being informed that...
Can we go back to Dave, please?
Yeah, let's go back to Dave.
Guys...
Uh-oh.
Oh, hell yeah.
Woo. What's that thing those kids do? Whoa.
Try me, bitch.
Stop it.
Ah, good times.
Good times indeed. No more sidetracks, sorry?
Agreed. No more sidetracks.
All right, Jill, you have something important to say?
Yeah, Jim, it's pretty important. As I was saying before, I'm being informed
that... Alright, that's all the time we have for today. Goodbye, everyone.
Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? There's 72 tornadoes sweeping through Tornado Alley! There's snowstorms raging in the Sahara Desert! Snowstorms! In the Sahara Desert! Does no one care? There's a small army of megalodons preparing to eat the state of Florida! Oh, but no! We have to see what fucking Dave is up to!
Jesus Christ, Jill, what's your problem?
Jealous.
The child lock was on. Let us go.
All right.
Why do people continue to think that jewels are biodegradable?
Environmental Oral! You have to come with us right now.
Am I being kidnapped?
No, we have to help you not get murdered.
Sure. Don't you have some way of proving someone's not trying to murder me?
Jesus Christ, man! Have you been watching the news? Or following the investigation of over 50 dead YouTubers?
I don't know why you, a YouTuber, thought it safe to film unguarded in a location where a cultist could easily come out and leap out of, like, a bush or something.
Yeah, what the hell is wrong with you people?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I recycled my television last week, okay? I don't know anything about Maple or cult or whatever. I'm just trying to raise awareness, and all you guys are trying to do is stop me. Now, do you see this field? That's the El Palm Historical Landmark. Now, this is where the cavemen and the
ancients... Look, man, can you just come with us, please? No more excuses.
I beg of you, Earl Summer.
Now, look here, climate haters. I know you don't care about the Earth melting away at our feet, but I do. Now, if you'll excuse me.
I prepared for this. Earl, you know what this is? It's an AC remote. You see, for every second you make us wait, I'm going to turn down this remote by 2 degrees. You know, AC pollutes the environment more than anything else.
You wouldn't dare do that.
Oh, yes, I would.
No, I'll cave, I'll cave, I'll cave.
Well, you better cave faster, goddammit!
What the fuck is up with this thing?
I don't fucking know, you ignorant twat. My nips are fucking more solid than the goddamn iceberg on the Titanic. This is the worst Tesco I've ever been in my whole life. You don't have cheddar Pringles, your shelves are stocked like shit, you don't even have fucking paper towels that are not fucking already open! You just lost a paying customer!
No! I'm ruined!
Okay, where are we going?
We're going to my car. We have to get out of here before the cult arrive.
Okay. Wait, there's some trash over there, I gotta go pick it up.
You realize people want to kill you, right?
I'd rather die than see the Earth suffer.
Don't make me, Earl.
No. Ripping out that blade of grass just dropped the amount of oxygen in the atmosphere by 0.00000.
All right, I get it. More believable than climate change.
Is there 1%?
It's okay, Earl Sama. I don't see any cultists around. Just make it quick.
Got it.
Wait.
No! I need more oxygen to fight my way out now!
What have I done?
If only someone saw this danger ahead of time.
Oh! God damn it! Can we do one thing, right? Just one thing!
I agree. That's why I should use my time travel jutsu. My last resort.
Well, thank God.
Hey guys, I think I found a clue. This could be really big for us.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Weeaboo Guy, I really think you should use that time traveling jutsu, man.
Come here. Look. Cult meeting at 5. There's an address here and everything. Guys, we have no chance of beating them defensively, but maybe if we take them by surprise...
We can lynch them.
Please just say kill them.
Oh, I need to use my underground legend station for something, man.
You're what?
Are you guys ready to do this? Let's go.
Finally, things are looking up.
I don't know, guys. Who's to say this isn't like a trap or something?
We've been looking for ways to get a leg up on the cult for years now, it feels like. This could be a trap, but we don't have a chance if we don't take it. Plus, if it is a trap, come prepared.
Come here!
All right now, no one needs to get hurt. Just let us take our guy and you two can be on your merry way.
Let me go.
Police Chief Brown is gonna be really disappointed in you. Maybe he'll finally make you turn in your badge.
Hey, nincompoops. I don't know if you realize, but the guy who you're really looking for just got away with another murder and could still be in the area.
Stop wasting your time with us and go after them. We have the same goal.
But we have the legal right to do this. You guys need to see that we can bring justice without any help.
Yes, we do. If we work together, we can get them in no time.
There's no use negotiating. I'm done doing that with these people. Are you? We're going to end this cult one way or another. And if you continue to keep my friend hostage, I'll have no choice but to show you my 1,000 paper cuts technique.
All right, samurai jackass. Take one more step forward and I'm putting a bullet straight in your friend's skull. And my partner here is gonna open fire on you too.
Come on, Mao. We can take them.
Just go, guys.
You have everything you need to put an end to this. Hell, I've been bringing you guys down. You know, the grass I pulled out earlier? Probably still alive. But you guys got everything you need to finish this. Just go without me.
Watashi wa amata, ukutase imasu. Your skills do not define you, Gilligan. Your heart does.
Weeaboo guy, let's get out of here.
He's right.
I wasn't lying. If you guys leave now, we won't pursue you.
Are you sure, Gilligan, son?
I believe in you boys. Go!
Are you kidding me? Why'd you let him go? That's the closest we ever gotten.
Are you serious, dude? I don't want 1,000 paper cuts. Besides, we have all the answers to where they're going right here.
Hey, easy there,
hey,
brother.
There's nothing easy about me, bro. I crush Lemmy.
Good work, boys. You're dismissed. Gilligan, I'm very disappointed in you. You know, I've always believed in second chances. Remember last year when I sent you to the hostage negotiation and, well, you lost your cool and a lot of people died? Don't think I need to remind you. You know, I thought there was still some good work left in you, but I might have been wrong.
I'm sorry I let you down, sir. I'll see myself out.
Hold on. I said might have. There's a way you can earn this back, Gilligan.
Well, how can I do that? I haven't done anything right. I don't reckon I deserve a second chance.
Lead us to the vigilantes.
But sir, they're just trying to help.
I don't care what their intentions are, Gilligan. They're getting in the way of this investigation, whether you realize it or not. Once we get them out of the way, we'll have the butcher behind bars in no time.
But sir, we gotta help you put the butcher behind bars last time. You're likely gonna need him again.
I don't know what your friend told you, but the El Palm Police Department worked tirelessly to solve that case. Not with the help of some katana-wielding maniac.
But
who are you gonna believe, Gilligan? The man who always gives you an undeserving second chance? Or the man who you literally refer to as a derogatory term?
I do that with a lot of men.
Gilligan, I'm giving you a way to get back into the fold. If you lead us to them, I'll take you off traffic duty, and me and you can end this case together. But if you don't, you'll never see that badge again. And Meadown's death would have been for nothing. And the cult will continue to ravage this town for God knows how long. Gilligan, you can finally put an end to this. Those vigilantes have killed men before their day in court. They're just as bad as the cultists. The choice is yours.
Seems like most of those devils are down there. I say, we go and end this once and for all.
Weeaboo guy, we have to be sneaky about this. One bad mistake and we're through. There's no going back.
Agreed. What the hell was that?
Mao chicken. The hell, man?
Do you have any other pets I should know about?
No.
Okay then. Shall we go?
Wait.
You ever cosplay?
This, my friends, is one of the last steps in our plan. We have located the greatest threats to our plan and have concentrated all efforts into eliminating them. Now we start phase 3 of our plan, to take over the internet. But before we do that, I must make my intentions very clear. Therefore, I have prepared this convenient slideshow for your mandatory viewing. If I could just get my
Okay. Hey, here comes step one. This guy's pretty good, right? Well, I guess. We are in that cult following him after all.
His name is Maple. I knew that. Good?
I don't know what I'm thinking.
Good day.
Maple. Remember what happened to Gary last week?
Maple is coming.
I don't give a fuck about what happened to Gary.
What? What? Why did he say Maple is coming? Isn't that something we say? No? Eddie says that sometimes, but we don't really say that. It's not like we're Hail Hydra, dumbass. I thought that was our catchphrase. Are you telling me you don't know our catchphrase?
Nice going, idiot.
What's their catchphrase? I don't know. Excuse me, sir. What is our catchphrase?
Gary? Gary, is that you?
Yes. Yes.
Gary? Gary, oh my gosh, Gary, I thought you died 2 weeks ago! Come give your lover a kiss.
As I was saying, we take out the vigilantes this time.
Gary?
That is it.
What? Scoundrel. This is working. We're getting some serious progress done here.
Yeah, dude, totally. Kind of excited.
Wait, so you mean to tell me the way you've been talking to me for this entire time has just been an act?
No. Good.
You? What the hell? You know him?
Guys, we're being invaded!
Stay gone!
Dude, you just chill out? Jesus Christ.
That guy. Me and Gilligan arrested him. I don't know how he could have gotten out.
You're a man, the butcher. There's something happening here. Something's not adding up.
There can only be one explanation.
They earned up my 5 coffee for $3 deal and broke out?
What is it, Mao-sama?
The force has been compromised.
More like my gas station has been compromised, right? It's like my 5 coffee for $3 deal. It's a steal of a deal, right?
This isn't good. They took Gilligan. He could be in danger.
You're right. We have to save him.
More like you can get the energy required.
God damn it, Akuts! Nobody's gonna buy 5 fucking coffees from your stupid gas chain. You'd be lucky if they bought like 2 coffees. Nobody is going to buy 5. They're not like waters or something where you can store them in their backseat and just forget about them. They're fucking coffees, Akuts! Nobody in their right mind is gonna buy 5 fucking coffees and drink them all. You're a fool.
You're gonna need 5 coffees for $3 where you're going, boys.
Oh shit, I have to hide my opium.
Look, sir, I can guarantee you wherever you're taking us, I'm not buying 5 coffees.
No. I think this is important.
I'll make it easy for you boys. Step out now and face judgment and live to see another day.
Never.
I'll face judgment when the butcher is back behind bars.
The only way that can become possible is if you turn yourself in. You're getting in the way of this investigation and I will tear this gas station down to make sure you don't interfere any further.
Go ahead!
No, don't go ahead! We surrender! We surrender!
We do not! We do not surrender!
Is this a bad time? Okay. I'm just gonna go.
Have a good one, man.
Enough of this. Where's Gilligan? If you harmed him in any way, There's no way in hell I'm ever turning myself in.
Boys. We've achieved nothing here. It's over for us. We've done nothing but get in the way. I think it's time for us to let the real professionals take over.
Gilligan, that's bullshit and you know it! Listen, we might not have succeeded as much as we thought we would have, but we sure did a hell of a lot more than these clowns. We investigated them, found their motivations, their hideout, even their leader.
But the cops have done that too. Maybe we weren't as smart as we thought we were.
Gilligan, listen to me. They didn't. Remember that cultist we captured?
The one we waterboarded? I mean, vigorously questioned in a very legal way?
Well, he's out. Listen, we infiltrated their hideout and he was right there, free as can be.
You're lying.
No, Gilligan. I was there. He speaks the truth. First the butcher, then a cultist. What do you think's going on here?
People don't just break out of prison. You don't think maybe, just maybe, the police might have broken them out for them?
Have you actually seen any evidence of the police investigating this humongous case?
I haven't. Gilligan, the police are compromised. There's no other way. There's no other explanation. They're a part of the cult. Why can't you see that?
I've been a cop my whole life. It's all I know. I trust them and I know they're right. I'm sorry, Mal, but I'm with the El Palm Police Department till the day I die.
Gilligan!
Good choice, Delgado. You ready to end this case with us?
Are we about to arrest those vigilantes and the brown gas station man?
We don't need any more of our good men dying. I called in a separate team to take care of them.
And bring them into custody?
Maybe, if they cooperate. That's not our choice anymore now, is it? All right, come on, boys. Let's complete this investigation.
Finally happened. The biggest thorns in our side.
Enough talk. You die now.
What he said.
Hey!
Why didn't you use that gun when you were getting robbed before?
I forgot I had a gun! Oh, my pelvis! I cannot run a business without my pelvis! Oh! Where are you going? Ow! Oh. I'm ruined!
Elmer Goodman!
This is it!
No, it's not! Who's that?
Who's that? He's the man you've been fighting alongside with this whole time. You? Yeah, I did my research on you, Weeaboo Guy. Turns out that nickname was a lot more fitting than you could have ever imagined, Mao.
You see, Elmer here didn't have a lot of friends growing up. Instead, staying inside all day to watch Japanese anime.
Dropped out of Idaho State, then dedicated his whole life to being someone he wasn't.
And look where that's got you. I'm out of prison, your wife is dead, and this whole town's about to be run by my organization. You failed, Elmer.
Except you're wrong, Eddie. He set out to be a hero. That is exactly what he became. He came back not for you or for his glory, because that's what he does. He's a vigilante at heart. If only you'd notice that.
You shall fall in this fight. This shall be our final battle. We'll win this one. Together.
Of course.
Can't fight me alone, huh? So be it. Give your wife my regards.
Oh!
Hey!
No!
You really think you've won? I'm sorry to tell you this, Elmer. There's nothing you could have done to change anything.
The cult is nothing without its leader. It's over for you boys.
It's funny, after all these years, you're still so naive.
Mao. Mao. Mao! Thank God. No!
You've lost. Maple is here.
Chitose, I don't remember
Mao,
the rest.
Mao, it's okay. You can call me Weeaboo Guy. I actually quite like that name. Makes me sound like a superhero. Besides, anything's better than Elmer.
Weeaboo Guy, get up! I can't do this on my own. Every time we kill a cultist, they seem to get stronger. I need you.
The road ahead will be a hard one. But, just like Zeppeli-san said in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Part 1, Chapter 6, Page 47, courage is taking that fear and making yourself stronger from it. Go, my friend. Maple's still out there, and it's up to you to finish this cult.
I will. Make them pay for what they did to you.
Good, Mao. Kore wa watashi no niho saigo no. Watashi wa no. My wife waits for me at the gates of the afterlife.
No. No! Wake up! Wake up!
Thank you.
I hope you make it up there safe. I'll see you there soon.
This is impossible.
Nothing is impossible. This Weeaboo guy fellow was a good man.
He was.
I will make sure he gets a proper burial.
Thank you, Akut.
This seems kind of wrong, isn't it?
It's what he would have wanted.
Is it?
No time in asking pointless questions. I have to take care of my gas station. I don't even know if it's standing. Rob could be having his own Diwali celebration right now with my money. I just wish we could change all of this.
What's done is done. Can't be changed. Now, let's put an end to this cult. If it comes down to it, I'll do it myself.
What are you doing?
His favorite color was always blue.
But that's you, sir. Good luck, sir.
All right, are you ready?
Are you sure about this, Chief?
Yes. If we want to take over this town, much less the state, we have to get rid of Gilligan. He's the last remaining threat to this operation. I tried to get him off this case many, many times, but he failed. It's a shame he got caught up in this mess. It won't matter once the world is pure. At least he did one good thing before he died.
Maybe he's not a total fuck-up after all.
Davis, you know we have guns, right?
Good point, Walton. I'll go grab my shotgun. Be back in 1 minute. What the hell? Which one of you boys took my...
Mao, I got here as quick as I could. I know the police is part of the cult, and I've known it all along, but you see, I thought I could do some infiltration work. So I waited till the right time, and then I took out two of them, and I stole the shotgun, but then... Wait. Where's Weeaboo Guy?
Mao, what the hell's gotten into you?
He's dead! He's dead! Where the hell were you, Gilligan? Huh? Playing tic-tac-toe with your goddamn cultist buddies?
For all I know, you're one of them now. They sent you to lower my guard and then take me out. Huh? Good thing I'm not dumb enough to trust your corrupt ass again! Back at the gas station, you said you were with the police department till the day you died. Well, I got good news for you, Gilligan. Today is that day. This time I won't give you time to go back on your word.
You won't shoot me.
You won't!
You don't have the balls.
You're right. Well, about that first part at least. I'm not gonna shoot you, brother. We're on the same side.
Don't you ever fucking call me that, scumbag.
This is your final warning, brother. I don't want to kill you, but if you force my hand, I know I can finish this investigation by myself.
Nice try, Gilligan. I know with your aim you can't hit a broadside of a barn.
You're about 2 feet from me, Mao. You really want to take that chance?
Oh!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What are you guys doing here? Acting like some dumbasses on this mortal plane. I could feel it from the afterlife.
Larry?
What the hell?
Larry, I thought you died, brother.
If you think death is real, well, then I did.
How the fuck are you back?
I'm Larry fucking Mintz. How's my sub count?
Well, let me see.
Larry, how'd you gain 2,000 subscribers?
I've been using my enlightened state of thinking, making people think that I'm Jesus Christ or something. That they gotta follow me to go to the afterworld. Smart, right?
Larry, that is fucked.
Religion is fucked. It's all an institution. A scam.
Wait, so if there's an afterlife, is heaven real?
Well,
is hell real?
No time for that. I was looking down upon heaven on you boys, and you're about to get fucked.
What? How would you...
Why is this guy always saying what or how? Who is this? Aren't you a detective? Aren't you supposed to know stuff?
Hey man, catch me a break or something. This is all pretty fucking weird, right?
Hey man, I hate being in your dimension too. It's like being on two tabs of acid and shooting heroin in your knee.
Larry, I'm sorry I let you die, man. I'll make those cultists pay. I'll kill every last one of them.
It looks like you've learned nothing from me.
Well, I didn't.
Well, guys, don't kill the cultists. They're just like people, like you and me. They just want a better future for themselves, but they're misguided by hate.
They're killing innocent people. They've killed 50 people so far, and counting.
On their leader's orders, you're no stranger to killing vigilante, dude. You kill for what you believe in all the time.
Wait, but hold on. Back at your place, you were killing cultists left and right. What's up with that?
I talked to one of the guys that the bear Jew killed in the gas station fight. He was a great guy, an ex-Marine, on the way to curing cancer, so many other things.
Oh my god. Really?
Yeah, and it gets worse. He had a pregnant wife at home, and his dad was-
Whoa, okay, Larry. We get it.
God, I fucking hope so. Have some compassion. Anyway, you're surrounded by a bunch of cultists whose main sole purpose is to try to kill you.
What?
There you go again, asking fucking questions. Just listen. Alright, I've had enough of this shit. I'm dipping.
Wait!
Is Weeaboo Guy there?
Oh yeah, I saw him on the astral planes. He was just some Asian chick. He looked happy. Alright, so goodbye.
Now we have to get ready. It's okay.
Oh, it's not. I'm glad Weeaboo Guy's in a better place, but I'm the reason he died, man. I was foolish, and I was weak, and I couldn't
Now hold myself. On right there, Mao. We all mess up sometimes. I ain't no stranger to it. I'm sure that doesn't surprise you. I've made my fair share of rash actions before. We all fuck up, but we just have to learn to live with
it. I'm not sure that your fuck-ups compared to this, Gilligan.
I'm stuck on traffic duty, Mao. Do you ever wonder why? It's like countless innocents die just because of my rash decisions, or I just couldn't wait for backup. Do you know how many funerals I had to attend knowing I was the only reason they still weren't here? Your families would always come up to me, thanking me for doing the best I could, but... do they know I might as well be the murderer myself?
Killing.
It's not the point. We're fuck-ups, but we're fuck-ups together. Our actions have caused a lot of pain. That means it's up to us to make it right. By stopping that cult. Are we good?
Golden.
It's good to hear. Because we got some uninvited guests. I'm not about to wait here like the sitting duck for them to come to us.
Look at this. The culmination of all our power. Many people banding together to make a difference. And now, look at the culmination of the opposition. Just you two.
Oh, really? Because from what I know, from what we know, the rest of the world is against you. The only ones that you still have are right there.
And where is the world to voice its opinion? Oh, that's right. Being distracted by the superficial things that society has surrounded them with. The whole world will be on our side once they see our message, and society will finally be pure again.
Who gave you the right to decide that?
You did. You all did, by displaying your utter incompetence. You think we're outliers, huh? Well, where are your police buddies to help you put an end to this madness? Oh, would you look at that? They're all behind me, ready to make a real difference. Maybe it's time to realize you two are the villains, and I'm the hero.
Hero! Don't make me laugh. You're a pussy! You had the butcher do all the work for you while you stood behind this stupid cult. You are nothing!
But you have to realize, I'm everything. I'm the delegator. Do you really think that Brute could do everything? Who do you think broke him out? Who do you think organized this entire thing? Things have to get messy in every revolution now. If a couple of eggs have to be cracked, so be it. I converted Eddie, and Eddie converted the police.
Except before or after you broke him out.
You don't get it, do you? Eddie willingly got captured so we could gain control of the Alpine Police Department. It was our plan all along. The whole butcher thing was just a red herring. What? Do you really think a Japanese poser with mediocre fighting abilities could stop a serial killer who had a death grip on an entire town? That's amusing. Elmer Goodman was a joke, but more importantly, he was nothing.
He was more of a man than you'll ever be.
Why be a man when you could be a god? And change the entire world as we know it. That's what I'm here to do. That's what we're all here to do. To make the world a better place. And for that to happen, you two have to die. It's just as simple as that. And you won't stop Maple's arrival.
It's always been your downfall, Gilligan. You've never had any foresight. Also, where's my shotgun?
I broke it.
You're gonna pay for that.
And your downfall's been underestimating me.
Nowhere to run now. And you don't have your little buddies to help you out either. Like I said before, nothing. You're nothing but a pussy. Fuck!
here.
That's my last bit of advice to you, Gilligan. When you cut corners in life, always have a backup plan. Too bad you'll be too dead to use it.
You know, Police Chief Rogers, I always told you you should wear a bulletproof vest too. I guess you should have listened.
I've been working in the force for a long time, Gilligan. No matter how many criminals we caught, more would make their way on the streets. I thought this organization would put an end to it.
You're wrong. They murdered innocents. There's no peace or good outcome in that. You cut corners, Chief, and there's no good backup plan to undo that. You know, I could still patch you up and save your life.
No. Put away by the same force I've been working for all these years, just let me die.
Very well, sir.
You're a good man, Gilligan. You'll make a fine police chief. Better than me.
Thank you, sir. Oh, wait, Police Chief Rogers, one more thing. About your wife, it was me. I was sleeping with her. We're second cousins.
According to law, that's not technically incest.
Fuck!
How did someone as small as yourself expect to stop such a grand movement?
I was just about to tell you, bitch.
Come on, let's go get him! Well, we'll have to work. Oh, you can't-
Oh, now hold on, brother! We still have some questions we need to be answered.
Wait, who is this?
Environmental Earl. One of the YouTubers we thought was dead. We thought. You seem like such a kind philanthropist.
I am.
Then why would you do something as horrible as this?
It's a long story. You got the time.
Boss! We do now.
I've run my YouTube channel for 12 years now, and only a small group of people seem to care about my message. It took me 12 years, 12 years, to barely stay on the trending tab. Every single person on this planet pollutes and pushes the world closer to extinction, yet nobody cares. The way our society works now is that the basic necessities needed to live cause us to pollute. I wanted to spread my message to the world, and for years, no one cared. That's when I knew I needed to take action.
By killing innocents?
You wanted to save the world by killing people?
Not necessarily. The only way people will listen is if you make a little noise. I still believe in the human race, but we all need to unite under one leader in order to cause any real change.
But we won't be here for much longer, sir. I put aside 25% of my profits to invest in SpaceX when they go public. Any day now.
Creating a new society is the only way to change the world. YouTube was the easiest target, and the easiest cover-up.
But why the name Maplewood? Seems a little fruity.
When I was younger, I had a maple tree in my front lawn that I loved dearly. It was the beacon of my life. It brought me joy.
Aw, that's kind of nice.
And the maple tree told me to kill people.
Aw, Siva. Oh, Jesus, it all makes sense now.
He's too dangerous to be kept alive. Shoot him.
Now hold on, brother. We can't do that. I need to put him behind bars.
Behind bars? Really? Tell me, Gilligan, what happened to the butcher when we put him behind bars? Turned your entire little police department to a cult and broke out. Who's to say that won't happen again with Maple?
Well, I need to interrogate him to figure out how they did that to stop anything like that in the future ever happening.
Gilligan.
I will personally ensure he does not break out.
Gilligan.
I will interrogate him myself.
I made a promise. You understand that? I made a promise to Weeaboo Guy to keep this entire town safe from that cult. The only way we're gonna do that is by killing this guy.
Enough! I'm the new police chief of Elpon, and he's going into custody! That is final! Hey, Coops! You little fuck! Why on earth would you do that?
He disrespected me. He told me it was ridiculous to put 25% of my profits into SpaceX. His economic...
I want to hell with him! Someone needs to go to jail!
Hey!
I'm back, killing you.
Y'all are under arrest.
Gilligan, hold on.
Remember what Larry said?
Everyone, you're free. Now I know for the most part, you didn't join this cult because you shared the beliefs of your leaders. We're now deceased. You joined this cult because maybe you had some financial troubles or some debt you needed to pay off. Or maybe you thought you might have made a difference in this world. Your leaders thought the same. And now, they're dead, and you're left to bear their consequences. However, there might be a way, a cure, if you will. A solution where you don't have to go to jail for these crimes.
Mao, are you sure about this?
Hear me out. Your leaders, along with many of you, have killed creators. Leaving the internet without character. Role models to look up to. People to learn from. You started in this cult because you believed you were doing good for the world. I believe you still can. I believe you should become YouTubers to fix the problem that you aroused. Come on, guys. Let me know your vision. Like you, you're always on vacation. What do you come up with?
I'm gonna be your survival channel and help with, like, wilderness tips and stuff.
Good! Good, that's what I'm talking about! And you!
I'm gonna watch animated movie songs and yell about things that don't make sense!
That's not funny!
What about you?
I'm not gonna make YouTube videos. I'm gonna make RedTube videos. What kind? Feet? Alright, that's enough questions. You're free to go, sir. Go create.
I'm going on vacation.
What a flamboyant soul.
I hope you made the right choice there, brother.
I know I did. The real monsters are dead. They're gonna make a better future.
Let us get out of here. All this death is making my sinuses commit sati.
We did it, boys. The cult is no more. I know if Weeaboo Guy were here, he'd be up there smiling.
Amen, brother.
Good evening, all. We have some breaking news coming to you from earlier this morning.
It seems that all of our prayers have been answered. The YouTuber murder spree has finally been put to an end. Turns out it was run by a cult, led by one YouTuber named Environmental Earl.
As well as being run by Earl, the cult was led by the infamous El Palm Butcher, with the support of most of the El Palm Police Department. All the people trying to solve it were involved, no wonder it took so long. Did you at home see that coming?
Jesus Christ, Jim, this isn't fucking Dora the Explorer.
I was going for more of a Blue's Clues vibe.
Since the police department did not investigate, the case was solved by a few local heroes. The group included two vigilantes who are going to remain anonymous, and Gilligan Delgado, a rogue police officer, and a local gas station owner, Akuts.
A gas station owner? Well, I guess they have to be useful for something every once in a while.
They're very useful. Without Akuts' gas station's coffee, I wouldn't be able to wake up in the morning.
One can only dream, you soul-sucking bitch. Right, so we go over to Dave, who's out in the field interviewing the new police chief, Gilligan Delgado, on the matter. Dave?
Thanks, Jim. I'm here with new police chief Gilligan Delgado, who went against orders to investigate this entire cult ordeal. He, along with a couple of other local heroes, exposed the entire cult and put a stop to this madness forever. Gilligan, how does it feel to solve a case as big as this?
Well, it feels great, Dave, I tell you what. I've been training my whole life for this. I'm glad it finally paid off.
Would you like to comment on the team that helped you put an end to the cult?
Of course. The two vigilantes who helped me deserve to be treated like heroes, and they were brilliant. One would like to stay anonymous, but the other one we unfortunately lost along the way. His name was Weeaboo Guy, and without him, the cult, as well as the El Palm Butcher many years ago, would never have been brought to justice. He was a hero. I know he rests easy knowing we brought justice to this town.
Weeaboo Guy, huh? What a strange name. And what about local gas station owner, A. Cooch? Would you like to comment on him? Sir? Would you like to comment?
This is my comment.
Ah, understandable. One more thing. How does it feel to be a Southern man?
Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful.
Great to hear. Well, thank you for your time, Gilligan, and congratulations. Now, back to Jim and Rachel in the studio.
Ah, Dave. Always a pleasure to see.
Dave, why did you have to leave us? Why couldn't you send out this bitch instead?
The feeling is mutual, Jim.
I highly doubt the feeling is mutual, Rachel. Stay next to this constant hell because you give me no legroom, you fat bitch. I hate you, Rachel. And the fact that I'm alone with you in the studio right now makes me want to tear out my eyeballs and eat them with mustard.
I'm still here, Jim.
Oh, really, Jill? Oh, are you? Well, I can see you pass this bitch sitting next to me. Well, after today, I doubt we'll be able to see anything at all from the gamma radiation emanating from his cunt.
Well, at least I'm not a lazy, alcoholic, dumb piece of human garbage whose greatest achievement in life is being at the top of El Palm's registered sex offenders list. Wait, no, John, put us back on air.
Oh yeah, Rachel, well, at least I don't hunt down disabled orphans and wear their faces at deranged Halloween sex parties.
That was one time, Jim!
It was 19. Nine fucking teen. I was there for 12 of them. I was the one in the body mask.
12? More like nine. What are you talking about? Loving family here at El Palm News. I would like to send prayers to any person or family that has been affected by the cult activity that's been going on in this town for the past few years. You're disgusting. You're pungent. I wish I never met. I hope that we can all come together as a community and heal after this great tragedy.
You know what? At one of the Halloween parties, you literally... I'm not even going to say it. I can't say this right now.
Oh, yeah.
And
while I have you here, the pack of megalodons did, in fact, eat the state of Florida. And Florida is indeed
you yelling me with yours?
A national parade celebrating this event will be held next Wednesday. Thank you. God bless and good night.
Surprised to see you back here, Mao.
I had to make sure everything was cleaned up correctly.
Yeah, that's what the state police does. Get the job done.
A job well done they did.
You know, the offer still stands, Mao. I need the help and you'd make a mighty fine officer.
thank you, but I work for the people. I couldn't turn my back on them for any organization, no matter how changed it might be. It's just, there's too many rules, you know?
I understand.
Hey, but we'll keep in contact. If there's any town-threatening emergencies anymore, you let me know, all right? I miss him.
I do too. But you fulfilled your promise. You stopped the cult and you brought peace to this town. He can rest easy. Spend some time with his wife. Good work, brother. Take it easy.
Hey, you too, man.
Yes, it's the finally the day.
All right, bud, you're done.
I work here, man. Come on.
No, you're not. I'm fucking here.
God, business has been fucking booming ever since I killed Maple. Booyah, bitches! Rob, where you at? Okay, so I've been autographing bags and selling them for $200 a pop. And here's the catch. There's no chips in the bags. Woo! I am going to be rich! I am a celebrity! Yeah, boy!
Yeah, boy! You've been in my head through my day, in my bed, smelling like maple. From your skin, and your friends, don't do shit. I wonder how you've been, where you've been, in whose bed, in whose heart. I tried to be playful, but you said that we do. I can't do friends, I wonder how you've
Shorty
been.
Shorty cut me off, she don't wanna talk, she just wanna flaunt. Shimmy up, fucking on my bra. Yes, I paid the cost for these silly thoughts, but I was on tour, love was not involved. How am I so wrong?
Used to tell your friends I'm your boyfriend. Boyfriend, boyfriend, I should be rejoicing. I'm a free man now, that's cause of my choices. But every time I try to move on, I hear these voices. Cause you've been in my head, through my day, in my bed, smelling like maple. From your skin and your friends, don't do shit. I wonder how you've been, where you've been, in whose bed, in whose heart. I tried to be playful, but you said that we do. I can't do friends, I wonder how you've been.
Trying to know ways that I could've been moved. Stacked on this paper, it's spread out you. Best get your pants all over the room.
Da 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 da